What's up, YouTube? We got another watch vlog today. Been on my watch collecting journey. Today, went back to Watchbox because I purchased a discontinued watch. It is the Rolex Explorer 1 from 2018. They were making 39 millimeter case sizes for the Rolex Explorer 1. But I think last year, or this is the last year they discontinued it. And starting this year, they only have 36 millimeter and 40 millimeter for the Rolex Explorer 1. 40 is, it's an all right size, but I wanted something a little bit smaller. And 36 is like a little bit too small for my liking, although I know that's the classic size. If you're watching this, you might think, oh, an Explorer 1? Why would you buy an Explorer 1? I hear so many people talking shit about it. So before I was into watches and nerding out, I thought the Explorer 1 was like entry level, like the cheapest Rolex you can get. It's what you buy when you really can't afford anything else from Rolex. Totally untrue. Actually, I've heard even like watch dealers on YouTube talk about the Explorer 1 being like, hey, if you're like 30 years old or 40 years old and you're wearing a Rolex Explorer 1, I hope that's not your dream watch. I think that is the absolute incorrect way to think about the Explorer 1. Yes, it is not as expensive as others. It is more affordable, especially along the lines of the Rolex products. To me, it is a quintessential watch. And it's so simple, so elegant, so beautiful. There's no bells and whistles, no frills. It's just a clean, sleek, timeless, classic looking watch. And I was on the hunt for it. Had to go to the gray market, as I mentioned, because it's discontinued. Went back to Watchbox. Alex hooked me up again. This watch came all the way from Switzerland, made its way to Philadelphia, and now into my possession. But let's talk about this, the history of the Explorer, just a little bit before we get into the unboxing. What kind of drew me into the Rolex Explorer 1 is the history behind the watch. Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay, sorry if I butchered the name, in 1953, they climb Mount Everest. Edmund's wearing some type of watch, I can't remember, but his guide Tenzing, he's wearing a Rolex Oyster Perpetual. That's what people believe, or it's a fact. I'm not quite sure. I'm not that much of a Rolex history buff. I literally like Googled it right before I started filming this thing. But I did know that it was named after these guys that had climbed Mount Everest. So Rolex, in honor of Tenzing wearing an Oyster Perpetual, they're like, hey, let's release the Rolex Explorer. I would most certainly describe the Rolex Explorer as a sports watch. Like, just even like the numbers on the dial, they look fast, but it's very understated, very subtle. It's unlike, you know, the Daytona. There's no diamonds on it, there's no sub dial, just very clean. And I think you can definitely pull it off as a dress watch. But what I imagine myself wearing when I rock my Explorer, white tee and jeans. I was like, this is the perfect white tee and jeans watch. So simple, straightforward. It's not like obscenely gaudy. I'm not sure what the watch says, how other people will perceive you as you wear it, because I've heard so many negative comments about the Rolex Explorer 1. But for me, what I'm trying to exude while wearing it is that, you know, I'm just chilling right now. I'm just vibing, having a good day. It's a regular, casual, chill, laid back. I ain't doing shit. I'm just kicking it with my family, my friends, whatever. That's the vibe I'm going for with this watch. Probably not gonna wear it with a suit. I'm not gonna wear it like, I mean, you know what? It can even be really hype-beasty, honestly. It's very versatile. And that's why I want it. And I just love I love a black dial on Rolex. The Rolex font just kind of pops off. I like the numbers on it because I was kind of going back and forth. I was like, should I just get a black dial Oyster Perpetual, which is like obviously very simple, clean, elegant, or should I get the Explorer? I was like, I don't want an Oyster Perpetual and an Explorer 1. They're like so similar. I think they're pretty much essentially the same watch based on what I know. I could be wrong. If I'm wrong, just flame me in the comments. Even though it's not like a crazy expensive watch or even like a super rare watch, Man, something just kept drawing me to it. And when I found a 2018 39mm full set at Watchbox, called up my boy Alex, I was like, yo, send this shit over. Another thing that I really like about the Explorer is that the model is just, you've got one colorway, that's it. It's gonna be the stainless steel oyster bracelet. You got the black dials, nothing else. There is no other choice, but except starting in 2023, I think now they're doing like a two-tone oyster stainless steel gold. The two-tone, I have not yet warmed up to it. Maybe my lack of watch knowledge is still veering me away from two-tone. So I knew I wanted just the straight stainless steel black dial. And I knew that I wanted the 39mm. I'm so glad I went with the 39. I think it's the perfect size. It's just got kind of a more like vintage flavor to it because of the case size. I think right now, bigger case sizes are very popular. 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. I think 39 is like the perfect size. I have some Speedmasters that had 39. I like the way it hits my wrist. Freaking gorgeous. I want to put a NATO strap on it, which some people might find sacrilegious, but I do really see this as a very casual watch. White tee and jeans, as I mentioned. I think like a wolf gray NATO strap, which I have two additional ones of those. I think I throw one of these on here. It's going to change the flavor of this watch. But I don't mind the oyster bracelet. I think it looks great. It's not much to hate in this watch because there's not much to it. And I think that's the beauty of the Rolex Explorer. Don't let anyone tell you that this is like entry level or the Rolex that people get when they can't afford other Rolexes. I can afford any Rolex I want. I absolutely wanted to have one of these in my collection, period. What's up guys, it's Saturday morning. I've had this Explorer for about a week, but I couldn't wear it because the bracelet was too big. And I'm super proud of myself right now because I am adjusting the bracelet on my own. I've been going to the AD and asking them to do it for me, but I was like, you know what? As a collector, I think I should learn like the basics. And I've done my Seiko, but this is the first time I've ever touched a Rolex. I've been very scared because I don't want to scratch anything. But I was like, fuck it. I gotta learn how to do this. And I'm almost done. I'm getting tripped up with like removing the bracelet entirely because I wanted to put a NATO strap on it, but I'll get there. I've got all the tools, but I definitely learned how to adjust it. I don't know why I'm recording myself doing this. I think I just kind of want evidence to show that yes, Eddie knows how to turn a screwdriver. Holy shit, you guys. I did something. April, I did it. I adjusted my own Rolex strap. Voila. No scratches. I used. Wow. Oh, you like it? Wow. Today's actually the perfect day to try out my new Explorer. We're going to a birthday party. Another one. 7-year-old, 8-year-old birthday party. We're going to be roller skating, so it's going to be an adventurous time. You know, Mount Everest, roller skating birthday party. There's no reason to wear a Rolex Explorer to a roller skating rink, but I'm going to because I just want to wear it for the day, kind of give it an honest review. You know, so we got the, you know, straight out the box review. Now I'm going to be rocking it and I'll figure out whether I like it or not throughout the day. You know what I'm saying? Really glad that I picked up the Explorer. Anyone that tells you that this is like an entry level Rolex or like a Rolex that you get if you can't afford to buy another one, that's fucking bullshit. Don't listen to that. I myself prefer the 39mm, which is discontinued, but it's a nice size for my wrist. If you're looking about getting a Rolex, you're like, oh, I don't know what to get. Rolex Explorer, I think, is probably one of my favorites, if not my favorite. Perhaps it's just, you know, what have you done for me lately type of situation, but I don't know, I really like it. Just plain, simple, clean, no frills, but beautifully designed, accurate movement. What more could you ask for? Shout out to Watchbox once again for hooking me up. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.